Then we have the instruction byte queue. What this does, now this the size is 6 bytes. It will fetch 6 instructions or instructions of size 6 bytes, and it will keep here. From here the decoding unit will take 1 byte and it will start decoding. So interface, bus address, segment registers plus IP. What are the functions of bus interface unit? External operations such as instruction fetching, read or write data to or from memory or input output devices, IO ports. So this interface is responsible. It will fetch the instructions as well as the data. Data can be fetched, either it can be fetched or can be written to or from the memory, whatever memory devices we have, or the input output devices. Then instruction queuing, it is a FIFO, that is first in first out, FIFO based queue, so that it will speed up the program execution. How we will fetch the instructions, we will keep it here and then from here it will execute. While executing, it can again fetch the instruction simultaneously, so as for which these two independent units are speeding up the execution time, speeding up the execution process, for which these two independent structures are there, and this process is known as pipelining. In pipelining there are two different parts, independent parts, and they can run parallelly simultaneously so that it can speed up the execution process. Then comes the EU, this part. Here this part is responsible for decoding and executing the instructions. Because we have here decoder unit, we will decode here, and whatever the operations are done, maybe arithmetic or logical, are done in the ALU. So for decoding and executing the instructions, it will read 1 byte instruction from the instruction byte queue. It will decode and generates address if needed. Whatever address is required, it will fetch and then it will start the operation. This part is completely isolated from the external world. That is via this interface only of bus interface unit, execution unit accesses the outside world, else no.